Hi, I'm Geek Squad Agent Meister from Best Buy, and I'm here with some basic tips on how to use your dual band router. So what exactly is dual band anyway? Modern routers can simultaneously transmit on 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, hence dual band routers. When you go to connect to a device that supports both 5 and 2.4 gigahertz, which most modern laptops, smartphone, tablets, even game systems do, you're going to see two networks related to your dual band router. For example, if you named your network My Home Wi-Fi, you'll probably see in the list of available networks My Home Wi-Fi, as well as My Home Wi-Fi 5G, or something similar. There is an exception that we'll talk about in a bit. When connecting a new device to your Wi-Fi, you'll probably be asking, which of these networks should I connect it to? While 5 GHz should cover most average size houses, 2.4 GHz does tend to transmit further, and it does go through materials like thick walls, brick, and similar a lot better. It's also really great if you're trying to use any outdoor devices in a larger yard. At the same time, you may also consider using this band for any of those network devices that don't necessarily need a fast connection. Smart home devices like a smart thermostat or a Wi-Fi printer work great on 2.4 GHz, and then that way they're not taking any of the bandwidth from your faster devices. 5 GHz is faster. In some cases, it can be up to 2 times faster, so it is the preferred network for your computers, tablets, smart TVs, and game systems. Now, about that exception we talked about earlier, some newer routers have a feature called band steering, or in the case of the Netgear, Smart Connect, which is meant to help decide automatically which network to connect your device to. So when you bring up the list of available networks, you're only going to see the one network name, for example, My Home Wi-Fi, even though it is still transmitting in both 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. The band steering will attempt to steer your device intelligently to the band that'll work best for it. Now, when you do have devices that do support both, it will tend to prefer 5 gigahertz. In most cases, this is a convenient way to use your network, and it's great for when friends and family come over because you don't have to explain which one they should be connecting to. On the other hand, if you do prefer to connect your devices to each of the networks manually, or you do need to troubleshoot an internet connectivity problem, you may go ahead and disable that feature. And with that, you're a little bit wiser about your Wi-Fi. We hope these tips helped. If you do need additional advice to help you make the most of your technology, check out the rest of our Tech Tip video series. Thanks for watching.